welcome to Knitgrit. In today's video, we're going to go over how to make this really cute accessory that will be for both Fall Guys, Among Us, and our Luna babies and squishes. I made a bunch of different sizes of these really cute crowns. So this one right here that I'm holding is the large size, probably extra large if I'm really thinking about it. It will fit the squish. I have also a medium and a small for the Fall Guys character, the Among Us character, and my baby Luna. I figured if they will fit the Fall Guys and the Among Us characters, I should make one to make the baby Lunas be able to be as royal as they would like to be as well. So I am doing three sizes, one size in this video, which is the small size. The Fall Guys and the baby Luna, however, are mediums. That is just really the big thing with this is that it is a repetition of four stitches, and I'll show you exactly how I go about doing that. The different sizes have different stitches. I'm gonna post all of the patterns up here so you can see it. You can take a screenshot. You can also download the PDF on Ravelry or on Lovecrafts, and you can get that for free for the first week if you use our coupon code right down below. So, you know, go ahead and go grab that. Otherwise, it will be for a charge after the first week, but for the first week you can get it for free. And I'm pretty excited with how this turned out. In today's video, we're going to be using a size D3 or a 3.25 millimeter crochet hook. I'm using my Furls crochet hook because I love them and I have an affiliate link with them. If you are interested in this, go ahead and click down below. You will also need a darning needle, some scissors as well, and for the yarn, I am using size 4 yarn. This is the I Love This Cotton brand. I just balled this already, and for this color, it is in the colorway of Curry. So I'm using gold. It's like this pretty yellowish gold color. I'm gonna move this away. I just wanted to give an idea of what the skein generally looked like. I've just been using this for a lot of stuff. I'm using this yellow as the yolk for my egg, which is a tutorial that I'll be coming up for my Among Us character, and I'll show you how I can actually attach that. You can keep this loose on your amigurumi, or you can sew it on top of their little heads, however you want. I've yet to figure out a good way to attach it other than sewing. So if you guys have any ideas for that, let me know down below, because I think it would be, you know, really helpful to be able to figure out a good way to get this to attach without it being able to have it ruin the look of it, basically. So basically, you're going to want to do repetitions of four when you're doing this. If you find that this is too small or this is too big, the difference between these two sizes is actually only one repetition. So I went and did 20 chains and split that across 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. So 4 times 5 equals 20. So just keep that in mind. Over here for the large one, I have this across 44 stitches because 44, again, divided by 4 is just 11 repetitions. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 repetitions of this little pointy edge here. I'll show you what I mean. So to start this, we're going to create a slip knot and re-angle our camera. And now we're going to take our crochet hook and we're going to put our slip knot onto our crochet hook. We're going to chain 20 stitches. So we're going to be making this smaller little crown here so that we can put it on a smaller amigurumi. We are going to chain 20. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. I'm gonna let that be a little bit loose for a second, and we're going to run our fingers down and straighten our chain line here. Make sure that it is going across and the front is all facing the front. We're then going to kind of hold our work and go back into our very first chain. We're then going to take our loop here and put it back on our hook and kind of pull it through that first chain. Now, I saw something that I actually really, really liked on Pinterest. No, I saw it on TikTok. There you go. And the way this girl worked through her chain stitches looked a lot different. I really didn't like how a lot of times when you work through just the front loop of your chain, the very top one here, it creates this, well, you can see it on the other side, this ridge of chains. Well, if you work through the back of that stitch, so instead of going through here, you go through the underside, it creates this smoother look. It's a little bit harder on the first one, like that. I'm also going to take my tail and work it as if it is a part of that stitch. So I'm going to start single crocheting into every single one of those chains. We have 20 stitches to go. And now that I've kind of moved to the back side, it'll make it so it kind of flips inside out on itself. That's okay. I'm going to go through the back stitch of each of these chains, basically. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I'm keeping my tail as if it is a part of my work the entire time. I find that that hides it. You can also tug on your tail just to make sure it doesn't get weird or anything like that. What number was I on? I don't know. I'm just gonna keep going around. The entire way around. It's luckily not that many stitches. This is a very quick accessory to just crochet up, and you can have it just on the side for one of your amigurumis. You can add it to one of your Lunas or your Among Us characters or your Fall Guys. I'm really excited. This was actually requested by quite a few people on both Instagram and also in the comments here. So, all right, we're getting close to the end. I'm going to double check how many stitches I have just to make sure that I haven't done anything weird. You're also going to want to keep your work straight here, and that can sometimes be difficult. I'm going to tug on my tail just to make sure that it's all lined up the way I want it to be and put this tail on the inside and kind of let it go there. All right, so now I'm going to pull my tail and I'm going to count. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. We need to do one more, which you can either do by really grabbing into this stitch, which is a little hard. There we go. Or you could just single crochet two inside that last chain if you get really frustrated. I've been known to do that. All right. So everything's facing the right way, and don't worry, that will look pretty seamless for the most part. We're going to go around one more time with these 20 stitches, and I'm going to go through. A lot of times people know that I go through just the front loop. For this, I'm going to go through both loops just to give it a bit more of a structural, like a strength to the structure of my crown here. We're going to go through both of the loops and just single crochet around. I'm going to fast forward through this little bit. And there we go. So now we have 20 stitches on our work. And so we're going to be working across. I'm going to try to just show this 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches in the same repetition. I'm going to post a little chart right here, and the chart's going to be a little messy until I actually explain it. We're going to skip our very first stitch here. So this is the stitch that we're skipping. See how my hook's inside of it? We're not going to put our hook inside of that one. We're then going to go into our second stitch, and we're going to initially just place 3 double crochet. So we're going to put 1, and yeah, it's going to look a little weird. It's going to look a little stretched right there. That's okay. 1, go back inside that same stitch. 2, go back inside that same stitch. 3, And now we have the right side of our little arch here. We essentially just made that 1, 2, 3 right there on that piece of the crown. What we're doing next is this little tiny bump on the top, and the way that you do that is you're going to chain 3, so 1, 2, 3. Keep your yarn kind of taut right here, otherwise you end up with weird loops and you don't want that. Place your hook inside of your first chain that you made right there and pull your loop through both. And that way, now you've got this nice little bump, and we're going to go back inside that same second stitch of the repetition, and we're going to place another 3 double crochet. So 1, back inside that same stitch, 2, back inside that same stitch, 3. There we go. So we technically have 6 stitches within that same stitch with also having a little bit of a bump. We're going to skip our third stitch. So this is our third stitch, and we're going to skip that, and we're going to slip stitch into our fourth stitch right there. Bingo boingo. And that is the end of our 4 stitch repetition. We skip, do our big old cluster, skip, slip stitch. I'm going to do that one more time to show you what it looks like when we're not just starting off with one. We're going to skip this stitch, skip that, and go into the next stitch. We're going to place our 3 double crochet on the inside. 1, 2, 3, all within that second stitch. And then we're going to chain 1, 2, 3, keeping it tight, keeping it taut. Go back inside that same first chain and slip stitch to create a bump. And then going back inside that second stitch of the repetition and go 1, 2, and 3. And then you skip and slip. Now I'm going to repeat this 3 more times because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these repetitions across this entire thing. And then I'll show you how I slip stitch off because it does look a little funky. And then I'll show you how I sew in my tails. I'll be right back as soon as that's done. All right, so we just did our last repetitions cluster. We are going to skip and slip, but I find that if I just slip here, it doesn't look completely slipped. So I like to actually go like right below that stitch. I know it looks weird and doesn't feel right. Oh no, and I dropped my stitch because of course I did. All right, we're gonna go back inside there and we're going to grab and slip stitch through that chain. I'm going to create a decently 6-inch long, 8-inch long, you know, tail. We're going to pull that through like so. And yeah, that doesn't look like it's completely closed, but it's fine. I'm going to grab my darning needle out of my Luna's head and knock everything over because, you know, I am known for my grace. And I'm going to take my darning needle and pull that tail through the stitch after that and kind of tug on it. That way it looks a bit more on par with what's happening over here, and I find that it matches it better. We're then going to work our tail through the backs of the stitches from our last round. We're going to kind of wiggle it around and go upward through all the backs of those stitches. I just kind of wiggle it through, and I try to go underneath at least 2 of these repetitions, and I do that by just kind of going in and out through these stitches and going back up and under and then under and through. There we go. I'm pretty happy with that. I try to go through at least two, but I tend to go around as many as I'm as patient for, you know. So now we're just gonna cut off all our tails, and that is pretty much all there is to it. This is a super easy, super duper easy pattern. Again, if you need the printable PDF for this, for the first week that this is out, it will be for free on Ravelry, and we also have it available on Lovecrafts, but I'm not sure how to make it free on Lovecrafts. I still haven't figured that out, so stay tuned for the update on that, if that ever does happen. I'm pretty excited with how this turned out. And I love that it can be used for lots of different purposes, for both Fall Guys, Among Us, for all of the different Lunas that I make. So, you know, there's that. Be sure if you enjoyed this video to hit the like button and subscribe to us. We have about 35,000 subscribers, and that is insane. The community building around this is kind of crazy. We also have Discord down below if you ever have any questions, or if you're working on something and you want to send along a picture and say, hey, Cody, can you help me figure this out? I can do that. I can help with that. So go ahead and join us on Discord. We have some fun over there. I post memes and I post all kinds of different things. I try to help out where I can. And we post videos fairly regularly. I've been trying really hard in the month of October to post a lot more regularly than I had been. So again, thank you for looking at all these videos. And I just posted right before this how to make this cute little amigurumi dead body from Among Us. And I also have the crewmate version of that. I'm working on the imposter. And if you want to see anything else from Among Us, let me know. I also made this cute little leaf to go on top of the head, so it will go like so. And I'm still trying to figure out exactly if there's a way to add this that will make it removable. So if anybody has any advice on that, let me know. If you want to help me brainstorm on that. I actually do get a lot of really helpful recommendations down below. Otherwise, this is just going to be sewn on to the top of the head because a lot of people have been requesting how to do the leaf hat. I'm also going to be doing the egg, and I'm also going to make a top hat that will fit the crewmate and the baby Luna and possibly maybe even the squish. If anybody's interested in a larger top hat to go for the Luna Squish, let me know. And we have some Patreon and PayPal links down below if you would like to find other ways to help support the channel. But otherwise, I want to say thank you to everybody for listening and for watching. If you've made it this far through all of my ranting, I do appreciate you, and I hope you're having a great day. Until next time, guys. Bye.